straight to the deepest secrets of different bills. Hey, don't the demon, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt, they try to bring me down. See me win. You ain't like me.
What's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in the video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like and let's get this video to at least 1,500 likes, okay? That'll definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't already done so, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community, as I've been uploading every single day since NBA 2K20's prelude and dub uploading every single day since 2K21's prelude. So hopefully you can appreciate that 9 a.m. and the 4 p.m. upload every single day, and you can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing. All right, now let's get straight into this video. So today we're going to talk about the three-point playmaker build. Once again, we're going to go ahead and show the point guard some love. As we all know, the point guards, or just guards in general, have been getting no love. Because the fact of it is that, you know, everybody's want to be a 6'7 demigod power forward. It's okay, though. We're going to make do. All right. So what we're going to do here is that we're going to go ahead and stay 6'3, 195, 6'7 wingspan. We didn't change much here. Don't need to change much, all right? Then what we're going to do here is we're going to go get our driving layup to an 82. We'll get our driving dunk to an 81. So, yes, this build will get contact dunks. We're going to go ahead and max out the staying dunk to 44 to get four badges here. Then we're going to go 80 on our mid-range shot. We're going to max out our three-point shot. And then we're going to go 74 on the free throw to give us 16. Then we're going to go 80 on the pass accuracy. We're going to go 80 on the ball handle. And then we're going to max out our speed with ball for 16. Then we're going to go 80 on the perimeter defense. We're going to go 87 on the steal. We're also going to go 73 on the defensive rebound. And then we're going to go 46. Wait a minute, hold up. Is that 46? No, 48. There we go. 73 and 48. Here, that'll give us 8 defensive badges. Then we're going to max out our speed, of course, and our acceleration. We're going to go 60 on the strength. We're going to go 61 on the vert. And then we're going to go 60 on the stamina. So as you know, as you've been watching previously on my videos for the last couple days, it has came to fruition that you do not need to have stamina at all, unless you are a primary ball handler, and it looks like you need to at least have 60. That's it. All right, so that does save you a lot. And to be honest with you, by doing these little things here, as you can tell, as time has gone on and I have been, I guess you can say, enlightened, or as more knowledge of the game and the backside of the game, just like the little, you know, stuff in the background that we don't really pay attention to, we know about, we start to figure out, then all of a sudden builds start to gradually start to shift, okay? So power forwards are still gonna be OP, but now as you can see, just looking at this build here, this build is not bad at all, and it's competitive. It's gonna actually can play in the park with no issues, and you can be able to play really well with a build like this. Now, the thing is, as we all know, you will get a +4 to all these things here. So let's just talk about that real quick. You'll get an 86 driving layup, an 85 driving dunk, right? You'll get a 99 three-point shot. You'll get 84 pass accuracy and ball handle. You get a whopping 97 speed with ball. These are things that other, like I said, the point guard, I mean, power forward builds cannot get, all right? You'll have an 84 perimeter defense, which also be attached to your lateral quickness. Now, obviously, you'll have a 91 steal. So again, you'll be able to play some really good perimeter defense with this build. And you also have a 77 defensive rebound. I did it more so to be able to get attributes, but at the same token, it's still gonna stand out to help you get those rebounds when needed. And then of course, you'll have a whopping 95 speed and acceleration, which is gonna be toxic all in all, okay? So you're looking at 4, 16, 16, and 8 in the grand total. Again, like I said, you know, the perimeter defense is attached to your lateral quickness. So I just want to stress that you do have an 84 lateral quickness. It might not be the quickest you can get, but if you go above that, it does change the name. So you're probably better off, again, using this build as one that will play off ball and not be the on ball primary defender, right? So we're kind of going back to the 2K21 current gen and before. So a lot of these demigod power forward builds, they're able to do both a little bit of everything. But when you're making these rare builds, you are going to have to go back to the OG style. Sometimes it's just dope to be able to go back to the classic of, hey, I'm going to be the scorer. I'm going to have my lockdown on my team, and I'm going to have my center or a spot up center or something like that. So, I mean, to me, those are some things that I truly do miss about the game. I love the fact that, you know, there was diversity. There were so many different builds on the court. Now it's just kind of like every single time I'm on the park and I look and it's loaded up and I see three power forwards, offensive threats and shooting guards, right? So, I mean, offensive threats and scoring machines. But anywho, all right, so what we're going to do here, you have some options, but I think that the most thing that everybody goes with is this going right here. This is like the ankle breaking shots. So to be able to get those, you know, hops, jumpers and stuff like that to be able to drop people. So, of course, you want to be able to get those ankle breaking shots. And then here you do have some options. You can go with the easy blow. The finishing moves, right, for those contact dunks, because you do have contact animations, or you can go with the limited range 3-point shots, or you can go with the reduces the impact of shots against pull-ups, step backs, and spin shots. So some people go both on these. So, you know, they get the ankle breaking shot and then they pull off some crazy shot, right? Here pull-up precision. So like most people go with it as a guard. So we'll go with that too. And then here you have it, my nephews and nieces, you have a 3-point playmaker, right? So let's do this. Let's go ahead and get this build to 99 real quick. Let's go over the badges, and of course, you know, we'll get you out of here, right? So let's go here. All right, so of course here, we just want to go posterizer first, and then this bronze badge, man, we can just throw it on. Let's just throw it on Slithery, all right? Obviously, you want to go, a lot of people like to go Circus 3s. That's what gives you the opportunity to go to Circus 3s. Hot Zone Hunter, Deep 3s. A lot of people go with, is it Rhythm Shooter, Stop and Pop, Blinders. And of course, you can kind of work around that, whatever avenue you want, man. Maybe you want to get Circus 3s on here and then maybe here. Like, you know, like everybody has their way of how they like to go about it, right? Of course, you want to get Ankle Breakers here. You want to get Bell Out. Handles for Days and Quick First Steps are must. You got to get Bullet Passer on at least gold and then get Unpluckable. You might want to adjust Unpluckable. Space Trade is another one you can look at. But again, as a rare build, there's not really much wiggle room you have there. And then here, of course, you do want to go ahead and get your clamps. You want to go, let me see, what do we have? See a Rebound Chaser just for kicks, because we do have that. We definitely want to go Interceptor, so let's go Interceptor. So that we'll probably do as an off-ball defender, all right? Just be able to get those intercepting lanes, okay? But yeah, there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the 3-point playmaker build. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you drop a like, subscribe to the channel as usual, your favorite old head Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon with the banger, man. You know, when I say I'll be back soon with the banger, you already know what day I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.